Hello students, in this lesson we'll study about the spikes. Let us see what is a spike and what are the requirements of a spike. Okay, so this is generally used for fixing the rails, bearing plates and chairs to the wooden sleepers. Whether it is rails or chairs or bearing plates, in order to fix all this to the sleepers, we use fastening called as the spike. Here you can see there are different types of spikes. So to write or start with, spikes are required to fix the rails, bearing plates and chairs to wooden sleepers. Now there are few requirements of a good spike. It has to fulfill certain requirements. The first one, it should be strong enough so that it can hold your rail, bearing plate and chair in the proper position. So that is the first requirement. The second requirement is that it should be easy to fix. So not only easy to fix, it has to be easy to remove also. In cases when you want to remove or replace the sleepers or rails or anything, it should be easy to fix also. It should be easy to remove also. So that is one of the requirement of a good spike. The third requirement is it should not get loosened under your vibrations. So if it get loosened, what will happen? There will be a disturbance in the gauge. The rail will get disturbed, the chair will get disturbed, the bearing plate will get disturbed. So it should not get loosened under your vibrational loads so that your gauge is maintained properly. So that is your next requirement. Moving on to the fourth requirement, it should be cheap at the initial cost, and the maintenance cost also should be low as much as possible. So these are the certain requirements of the spikes. Now in Indian Railways, normally there are four types of spikes available. So let's discuss one by one. The first one is the dog spike. See, this is called as your dog spike. Now why the name is given? Because if you see the head of this, this is in the form of the shape of a head of the dog, right? So that is the reason the name dog spike is given to this particular type. So this is one of the simplest form. This is nothing but how does it look? It looks like your nails, whatever nails you'll have at homes to fix your things onto walls. So it'll look somewhat similar to your nails. So if you see in the cross section, see, this is the cross section, this is the side elevation, and this is the cross section. If you see in the cross section, it will be in the form of a square. Square cross section will be there. And the lower end, if you see, it will be what? Blunt. Blunt, pointed, or chiseled. So blunt, pointed, or chiseled shape will be there. Now, where exactly you use dog spikes? So details about dog spikes, let me write here. So if you want to fix your flat footed rail to your wooden sleepers, we use the dog spikes. Why? Because they are cheap, they will maintain a better gauge, they will be easily fixed onto your sleeper and they can be easily removed from the sleeper. So for all these things, if you want to fix a flat footed rail to your wooden sleeper, you will go for dog spikes. Okay. Normally, if there is one sleeper, for one sleeper, you will use four dog spikes. See, now this is a sleeper, right? There, if you can see, this is the type of spike used here is a dog spike, right? So this is your sleeper. So in order to fix this rail onto the sleeper, you are using how many dog spikes? Four dog spikes per sleeper. Okay, if it is a straight line, you can go for or a straight track. So for straight track, you can go for 4. But if it is a curved track, you can go for more than 4 dog spikes if needed. Okay. Based on the intensity of the traffic which is coming on the railway track, you can vary them. Now, what they'll do is, if you want to fix a dog spike, normally holes of slight smaller sections than that of your spike will be bored vertically right through the sleeper, and then this spike will be kept into it and it will be driven into the holes. You should not put a larger hole. You should put a smaller hole when compared to your spike, then put this spike and then drill it inside. In case your spike gets loosened, what they'll do is they'll pull out this spike, plug the hole, that is fill the hole, and a new hole is bored, and then your spike will be redriven. Now, if this process continues repeatedly again and again, what will happen? There'll be no space left on the sleeper to redrive the spike. In that case, what will happen? That this sleeper will be called as the spike killed sleeper. Suppose there is no hole, no place for hole left, then it is called spike killed. And what you have to do, you have to replace that sleeper with a different sleeper. So this is how is the process of your fixing the spike to your sleepers. Now, the only disadvantage of your dog spikes is when there is a lot of vibration, they tend to loosen very easily under your moving load. And what will happen? This will in turn result in creep of your rails. So this is all about the first type, that is your dog spike. Moving on to the second type, it is the round spike. So this is your second type, rounded spikes. So you can see the name itself indicate that it is in the form of a circle or round shaped. So this is your cross section. If you see on the top how it is. So these are sometimes also called as rough spike. Okay, the other name for rounded spike is also your rough spike. So normally the diameter here will be 19 mm on the nail, and the top diameter will be of somewhere around 38 mm, or top, or what you can call head diameter. Right. Now these will be either cylindrical in shape or in hemispherical shape. So the length of these spikes, this length will vary for different gauges. So for different gauges, you will have to use different heights of the spike. So normally they will range from 195 mm to 145 mm. In between this range, you have the heights or length of the round spikes. Understood. Now, where we use this, as I mentioned, dog spikes are used for flat-footed rail. Now, if you are going for a bull-headed rail to wooden sleepers, then what you'll do, you'll go for what? Your round or rough spikes. Also, in case of points and crossings also, you'll go for your rough spikes. So, how these are driven into your sleeper is similar to your dog spikes. So there is no much changes in the same procedure. How you drive your dog spikes, you have to also drive your round spikes. So this is the second type. Moving on to the third type, that's called your screw spike. So they'll be in the form of screws, whatever you get in your houses. See, if you observe, these are all your screws spikes. So this all are the figures of your screw spikes. So they are tapered screw with V threads. So these are nothing but V threads. See here, you see the threads are in the form of V. So that's why they are called as V threads. Now normally this will be of circular in shape at the top with a square projection. So here there will be a square projection, and this will be circular cross section. Now again, the length of this spike will vary based on the gauges. So if you're going for broad gauge, you will have to use a length of spike which is 165 mm, and for different gauges they will be different. Now the advantage of this is they have double holding power when compared to your dog spikes, and also can resist the lateral thrust in better way when compared to your dog spikes. Okay, but the problem with this is they are costly and are little difficult for gauge maintenance. So that's the reason normally screw spikes are not commonly used in Indian railways. So the major disadvantage is what? High cost and maintenance. Even though they have double power when compared to a dog spikes, the cost will become very high, and hence this will not be used to a major extent. Okay, so moving on to the last type. The last type is your elastic spikes. So these are all screw spikes, and this is your elastic spike. So here, if you see the shape, this is the shape of your elastic spike. So there are many forms of elastic spikes which are patented. They will be provided with a steel spring, and the shape of the head is different. If you observe the shape of the head, it is in the form of a S shape. Okay, so now these are also used where these are used to fix your flat footed rail to your wooden sleepers. They have better grip. So these elastic spikes have better grip, and they will not get loosened so easily under the heavy impact loads of the train. So they will overcome the disadvantage of your dog spikes. But again, these are costly and not of much use in Indian railways. Normally in British railways, more amount of elastic spikes are used. So in Indian railways, we majorly use the dog spikes and the round spikes. So this is all about your spikes requirements and their types. Hope you understood. Thank you.